In this video, we'll look at a basic algorithm called Minimax, which is often used to create artificial intelligence in games. We will apply Minimax to Tic-Tac-Toe, a simple game where the objective is to get three pieces in the same row, column, or diagonal. The Minimax algorithm will search through every possible future state, and because of this, perfect play is achieved. To quickly demonstrate the concept, I use the Java library called Processing. You can find a download link in the description. The source code is also available in the description. Now let's go through the code. The AI logic is restricted to the function AI move. The rest of the code is used mostly for drawing the visuals and not that interesting. As you can see, AI move is a recursive function. It applies a move for one player and will then call itself to let the other player make a move. Both players try to maximize their own score. In this implementation, the AI will try to minimize the score, while we will try to maximize it. A score of 1 means we won, a score of minus 1 means the AI won, 0 is used for draws. At the end of the recursive calls, the AI function will return the best possible move. Since Tic-Tac-Toe is a draw when played perfectly, the AI will never lose, but it might win if the opponent makes a mistake. In games where the Minimax algorithm cannot search the whole state space, more advanced techniques can still make the Minimax algorithm useful. For example, by using an evaluation function to evaluate the state of the game. The AI will then no longer play perfectly, but will probably still be very strong. Minimax is not always very practical, but it is a useful tool for any AI developer. Let's end the video with what would happen if there was a tic-tac-toe board inside each square of the tic-tac-toe board, because why not?